It's not happening in 2020. It's happening today.
The world is constantly changing. Technology is taking charge of our lives. There are wireless earphones, smartphones that can perform a wide range of functions, advancements in the space sector, and so on. In the same vein, we might be closer to autonomous cars than we thought. With Tesla, Apple, and a number of other auto companies working on these cars, self-driving cars might become a reality very soon. These cars, in spite of our doubts and fears, are necessary for a number of reasons. In fact, with the rate at which the world is advancing, autonomous cars might just be what we need on our roads. Let's see how these cars will shape our future in the next few years. But before we get into the video, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel with notifications turned on so you don't miss any of the new videos we post. Let's dive right into the action. Reduction in accidents. One of the main benefits of autonomous cars is that it would greatly reduce accidents. According to recent research, 96% of all automobile or traffic accidents are caused by human error, which means that more than 90% of these accidents could have been avoided. Other research stated that with humans driving, there is at least one accident fatality every 90 miles, which amounts to 4.2 accidents per million miles. Driverless cars, on the other hand, have been designed to obey traffic rules and cannot be distracted while driving. Also, there will be one fatality in every 130 miles and 3.2 accidents per million miles. With self-driving cars, there will also be a considerable reduction in traffic stops. Unfortunately, these human accidents are responsible for at least 1.2 million deaths worldwide. Also, these crashes have a financial effect on countries where they happen. For instance, it has been estimated that these accidents cost countries between 1-3% of their gross national product, which is around $500 billion every year globally. Experts have reason to believe that with the introduction of autonomous cars, these accidents will be reduced drastically. The founder of Netscape, Marc Andreessen, tweeted in 2014, "Self-driving cars are a moral imperative. These cars will be better at making calculated risks and will not make errors of judgment like humans." This, of course, makes autonomous cars way safer than human drivers. For instance, Google self-driving cars have been on the road for 6 years, and in these 6 years, across 1.7 million miles, only 11 minor accidents have occurred, all of which had no major casualty. However, there's a major argument against the safety of autonomous cars, and this is a very valid concern. What if the car glitches? Since the car will be a self-thinking machine, what would happen if it experiences a glitch while on the highway? What if it gets hacked into? Right now, this sounds like a scene from the Black Mirror, but there is a chance that it is remotely possible. For example, in 2018, an autonomous Uber vehicle struck and killed a pedestrian who was just walking down the street. Also, a man who owned a Tesla X model, Jeremy Banner, was killed this year when he activated the autopilot feature in his vehicle. Nalin Gupta, the director of business development for ride-sharing software development company RideCell, explains, "Safety is crucial when it comes to autonomous vehicles, and for the public to embrace AVs, they have to be safer compared to human-driven vehicles. And partnerships between different component providers, including both hardware manufacturers and software developers, will be crucial in order to have fully functional, safe, and reliable autonomous vehicles that can meet stringent standards." And this is where the introduction of 5G comes into play. With this technology, drivers and car owners will be able to effectively communicate with their cars and other cars on the road, and this sort of communication will also exist between the cars on the road in a way that human drivers can never achieve. This communication will of course make it easier to avoid accidents, making a future of zero accidents even more possible. However, this would surely have an effect on the medical industry. This is because 13% of organs made available for donors are received from people who died from car crashes, and this is according to the United States Department of Health and Human Services. This means that the medical industry would have to find another way to get organs for critically ill patients. But help might just be on the way, since several laboratories are already growing organs in the lab, or even harvesting donor organs from pigs. This of course isn't ready now, and would take a few years before it becomes a reality. World-changing potential. Electric cars are gradually becoming mainstream, and if self-driven cars have become a reality, then the world would have an auto solution that reduces traffic, pollution, obeys parking requirements. Also, since self-driving cars can operate for anyone at any time of the day or night, it would provide nighttime safe rides. For late-night workers, university students, and will offer easy mobility for the elderly. Interestingly, this means that more people will be able to live independently, since they now have a car that will take them to several locations. Even though paratransit services are still available, they aren't as available in every area in the world or every city in the United States. For the blind, Alphabet, Google's parent company, is working on Braille and other tools which would make it easy for individuals with visual impairment to use autonomous cars. Also, this has a huge financial advantage, according to Gupta of RideCell. Cutting the cost of transportation from $2 a mile to 20 cents a mile will have a huge impact on how cities will be built in the future. Even at an individual level, AVs will forever change the lives of the elderly and differently abled people. people by giving them back their freedoms. Effects on the car insurance industry. Autonomous cars will have a drastic effect on insurance companies. But this effect isn't a positive one. Come to think of it, if the likelihood of accidents reduce heavily, why would there be a need for car insurance? According to McKinsey, 90% of auto accidents would be reduced on our roads if autonomous cars are introduced. Other research bodies have put the percentage at 75%, but the truth remains the same. The car owners will see no need to use car insurance companies. Also, minor and even major vehicle glitches will be covered by the manufacturer of the vehicle rather than the car owners. In addition, a report by Rand Corporation has indicated that drivers might end up choosing health insurance rather than car insurance. Reduction of CO2 emissions. One major way autonomous vehicles will affect our future is the reduction of major air pollutants. Since autonomous cars will reduce traffic congestion, this will in turn reduce CO2 emissions on our roads. A report from Ohio University reads, since software will drive the car, the modern vehicle can now be programmed to reduce emissions to the maximum extent possible. The transition to new-age cars is expected to contribute to a 60% fall in emissions. Reduction of travel time. According to a recent report from KPMG, autonomous vehicles might reduce travel time by an astounding 40%. AVs could also recover up to 80 billion hours that have been lost to congestion, commuting, and consequently reduce the consumption of fuel by another 40%. This also has an interesting financial benefit. If AVs achieve all that's been mentioned previously, this could cause the United States to gain at least $1.3 trillion in a number of years. The challenges it could come with. Even though AVs would come with a number of great benefits, there are a few challenges we would have to deal with. The most challenging one involves the subject of unemployment. First and foremost, there will be a reduced need for law enforcers and drivers, especially chauffeurs and ride-hailing drivers. To tackle this problem, Lyft suggested that drivers should become mechanics after they've been replaced by their driverless cars. But while this would be a solution for some drivers, it obviously isn't going to work for everyone. Also, truck and taxi drivers who retain their jobs would have to be trained all over again. Initially, they would have to learn how to complete tasks like remote monitoring or vehicle teleoperation. As earlier mentioned, the major concern will be safety. How safe will these vehicles be? Will accidents be considered to be reduced? Will it reduce pollution? When we have very sure answers to these questions, we will move to the next technological conversation. In the words of Lawrence D. Burns, former vice president of research at General Motors, a safety culture is essential. Safety must be overriding priority for everyone involved with the autonomous vehicles. While I was at General Motors in the 1990s, we had several tragic and unacceptable fatalities in our manufacturing facilities. In response, GM CEO Jack Smith benchmarked world-leading companies in workforce safety like DuPont and Alcoa and deployed their processes. At the heart was creating a safety culture. Jack made workforce safety an overriding priority for GM. We had metrics and targets and trained everyone, and it worked remarkably fast. We soon became a benchmark company. To create a safe world of autonomous vehicles, this is the model every auto company in the world must follow. Self-driving cars will surely affect our future in several ways, even in ways we haven't imagined. In the same vein, there will be challenges, challenges that no one could see coming. We may need to come up with technological solutions before the introduction of these AVs, solutions that can tackle unforeseen circumstances. When we have tackled these challenges, the introduction of driverless cars will be seamless, and its execution safe, simpler, and smarter. And with that, we wrap up this video. Thank you for watching.